Hello all you awesome people out there, my name is Takeru and welcome back to this let's play of Hyrule Warriors Definitive Edition, where we apparently have a new story part to go into, which is the Wind Waker. A new dispute... Disturbance? Wow. It took me way too long to read that word. And as always, we're going with the Hero of Time, or Hero of Hyrule, Hero of whatever he is, the Hero of the Warriors. Going with the Master Sword that should not exist. Still missing playing Wind Waker, by the way. I just do think this is one of my favorite Zelda games. That art style just looked way out of place. For some reason, because of all the 3D humanoids.
Though peace was expected to return to Hyrule after Ganon's fall,
the peace will never happen.
Ominous happened instead. A new world appeared, a world of a different dimension. Impa had summoned Link to Hyrule Castle. She asked him to investigate the strange happening. Once the preparations for his adventure were complete, Link set off. He entered the strange new world. It was a vast, mysterious dimension with an unfamiliar landscape. There, he met a girl who was battling monsters. Her name was Tetra. She was the leader of a gang of pirates, but she had become separated from her crew during the recent dimensional event. Though strangers, the two could agree on one thing. The monsters Tetra was battling had to be defeated.
Well, that is a good common ground.
To take on the enemy.
I did not see what anything in this was for. Like heart pieces and stuff. Ah, oh, Forsaken Fortress. Yeah, I see a lot of weird things down here. I do like that the monsters is the new types. And not the same that we have seen all the time. These last stones heals can't be broken. Oh, right. I vaguely remember playing this, but not really. But this is part of... what was it called? Legends? That came out for the DS. To really go this way. I don't know this map.
Look.
Can I use that for anything? Not yet. Okay, I need to stop these guys. Two more up here. At least they're stuck down here. Can't get in there. What I can do is go over here. And activate this. Okay, where do the game want me to go? Oh, there's a chest down here. Apparently that was what the game wanted me to do. How did I miss the chest out here? We don't talk about that. That was horrible. I got an ammo. With the hammer you can press to switch to trigger various events. You can also attack certain foes. Okay, that opened up something up here. Nice. Still had no clue what that boat has to do with anything. Oh, maybe... Yeah, there's one of those thing I can hit here. Bye-bye, bridge. Thank you. I do like the music in this area though. I know. Oh, hello there, bird. It actually gives me a little fairy tale vibes. That folk metal aspect. So it's Tetra. Can I actually? No. I forgot how low level Tetra is. Ah, never mind. I can't see the bird anymore. I do wanna get over here though. Because some enemies are on the move. Back to being mine. Oh wait, the bird is down here. Okay, I'll just check if I can actually attack it in any way, shape or form. Because my mission is to the keeps, but I think this one is more important to get rid of right now. And it ran away, okay. Get this one.
Okay.
Nice. Nope. Okay, I actually did not think that that would work. This should be a boat. So right now we're more on completing than fighting. Well, a map. I need to be off real quick. Okay, sometimes this is counterintuitive how you use this. Look like that is so easy to beat them by now. Okay. Put that down, that one up collected. Hello, Big Bird. So let me get real here quick. Okay, the bird disappeared again. Apparently he doesn't like being here when I'm attacking. You should be good now. I'm fine with them taking over that one up there just now. Of course, that is not Romingo. And a heart piece. I would guess. I'm guessing the heart container is for Tetra. So yeah. Could not be here, could it? No. Okay, seems fine. Tetra? Command... its position. Okay, at least that did not fuck up the command for Tetra. That should be the last thing we need to collect in this area. There we go! Easy as pie! I don't know if it's easy to make a pie, by the way. At least nice to see some new enemies.
In the new world, Link met the pirate leader, Tetra, and they fought valiantly together as allies. But it would seem their enemies were stronger and craftier than they had imagined. After claiming victory, Link looked into the sky to see a monstrous bird flying off into the distance.
Hey, keep flying away from me.
Squinting
Howard.
To get a better view, he saw that the giant bird was carrying something in its talons. Not something, someone. It was Tetra. Link had to do something, or she would be lost forever. He dashed off to save her without a second thought.
And a new... God. I actually don't know how many puzzles there are in this game, either. I just know there's a lot of collectibles, exactly what I'm trying to say. But yeah, that is one more down, so... We continue the Wind Waker saga in the next episode. So thank you all so much for stopping by. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. So take care, one, and goodbye.